This week's Toyota One-on-One, I'm joined by 49ers wide receiver Richie James Jr. AKA
Sensei Spunk.
Sensei Spunk. Where did the name Sensei Spunk come from?
Sensei came from the word, well, came from the show, the anime show, Naruto. And the word Spunk is actually my childhood name.
Childhood name. So where did Spunk come from?
I got a little spunk in me when I was younger, so one of my cousins, my older cousins, gave it to me. So I just ran with it. I actually didn't like being called Spunk until I got into college. So
really?
Yeah, I was not being called Spunk. You can call me Spunk to save my life.
Speaking of being named Spunk, you're one of the two guys who you see after a win doing a backflip on the field. What's the backstory behind this?
I think it was last year against the Raiders.
Oh, I just saw Richie James do a backflip on the field.
I think me and Kendrick Bourne was on the sideline just talking about the victory formation. We knew we were going to win. They knew I was going in there. And I was like, man, I think I'm going to do something. I was like, I think I'm going to do a backflip. And he's like, bro, it's going to be so icy, something like that.
And it's not just you now. DJ Reed jumped in on the backflip.
You know, man, DJ's been flipping in practice. Even K-1's been flipping in practice too.
Really?
So, you know, we all had our, you know, couple players that can actually flip. So it was pretty cool. You know, I just organically did it with him and it just took off from there.
So K-1's like sneaky. I never knew he was a flipper. Is it just like behind the scenes, like at practice?
What people don't know is K-1 is sneaky good at a lot of stuff. He's sneaky athletic, sneaky quick. One of the quickest guys I've ever seen, like, in person that play, like, it's unreal. He's probably one of the quickest guys I've ever tried to, especially trying to block him, it's probably the worst.
So Pro Bowl voting is now open, and not sure if you've gotten a chance to look at it, but you're in the top 10 votes in special teams returners. So kudos to that. Make sure you guys keep voting, NFL.com/Pro Bowl. But so who's a teammate that maybe is under the radar that you think deserves some respect and should be voted into the Pro Bowl this year?
I think the guy that we were just talking about is the perfect example, which is K-1 Williams. It's underratedly sneaky good. It's crazy if you see the stats and you watch the film and guys can't get it away from him. Like, he's strapping stuff up. He's locked down defense. And he's probably one of the smartest dudes in the game in that slot position.
Another thing about this receiving group, I feel like all of you guys are dancers. Are you included in this group?
I'm like that shy dancer. You know what
I'm saying? Shy
dancer. Yeah, I'm like
not shy when it comes to the backflip.
Yeah, I'm not shy when it comes to backflip because I'm naturally good at it. You know, dance is like one of those things where I'm good at it. Some dances I can do, some dances I can't. So I ain't gonna always dance all the time. You know, so I dance when I'm really hyped. You know, but for the most part, I'm in the background just chilling, vibing to the music.
Who would you say is the best dancer in the group?
Number one, KB. It's gotta be KB. He's teaching everybody else how to dance. He over here teaching everybody, like, he made the dance up. Like, he teaching everybody else to dance, like he made it up. So I'm giving it to KB. Marquise right behind him.
Okay.
Debo right there too, so I'm not gonna knock Debo out of the picture.
And then now you have Emmanuel Sanders, who also is a dancer.
And the man does dance too. So, man, we got some dance receivers, man.
You guys really do. So Richie, you're a Florida guy, now out here on the West Coast in your second year with the 49ers. How's California been treating you?
To be honest with you, nothing really can get more expensive than being in California. So ain't no pressure out here. You come out here, it's like, well, this is what I asked for, right? You know, I want to live out California, get the good weather and stuff, but this is what I asked for. But for the most part, it's been fun. I definitely enjoy my time being here.
So I'm gonna call you out for a split second because, you know, you're just talking about how wonderful California is and the weather. Meanwhile, we dropped to under 60 degrees.
Woo!
And Sensei Spunk is wearing a bubble coat.
See, what happened was, this is what happened. When you're from Florida, anything under 60, ain't really anything under 70, really, to be honest with you. Anything under 70 is pretty much cold. Like, and anything about it, we're in the Bay. It's a breeze.
The team will actually be in Sarasota, Florida for a week in between Baltimore and playing in New Orleans. What is the thing that you would tell your teammates they must do when they get to Sarasota?
You have to go to the beach.
You have to go.
Like, okay, if you Google Sesta Key Beach, it's been voted plenty of times in the last few years in Moyne Beach, so you have to go to the beach.
As we're wrapping up this Toyota one-on-one, we got to talk about the obvious, and that's that game ahead of us. That's the Baltimore Ravens.
It's going to be a great one.
It's going to be a great one. What was your biggest takeaway while watching that game?
Lamar. We got a defense that is going to be well prepared, so it's definitely going to be a game. I think it's going to be must-see TV, so I think everyone's going to tune in.
So, Richie, you're a dog guy. You actually have a husky by the name of Goddess. Mm. Where did the name come from? And tell us a little bit about Goddess.
Well, her original name from her previous owners was Aphrodite.
Okay.
And I thought it was a little too much, so I decided to name her Goddess. And she's really a goddess. It's a perfect name for her.
Richie, this was a lot of fun. Good luck in Baltimore this weekend. Hopefully you stay as dry as you possibly can.
Woo. With this green thing, I can.
That's it. Woo.